Do you hear that? Yeah, that. Do you hear it? And now I'm not talking about the sound of traffic that is near my neighborhood. I'm talking about that turkey that's gobbling. If you didn't hear it, well, maybe that's just because you're not using your imagination hard enough. So instead of imagining about a turkey, let's just draw a turkey already and have an amazing time going
south. To those family celebrations, passing on knowledge down through the years at the
What you will need for today's project is a piece of paper and a pencil, and then however you want to finish your art, with whatever art supply it is that you want to finish with. Here's the first turkey that I will teach you how to draw today. All right, let's start with our first turkey. We're going to start by drawing a small oval shape. Remember, draw light till you got it right. That way you can erase and nobody knows that you had it wrong. So, draw a small oval followed by a larger oval, and the larger oval is going to be lower on the paper. By the way, I have my paper horizontally, or some of you like to say that the paper is taking a bath. All right, so we're drawing the larger oval. So we have a small oval and a larger oval. Now we're going to connect those two ovals by coming off of the first oval, and we're going to come down and go in a little bit and then back out before we connect to the bottom oval again. We're creating like the neck part of the turkey right now. So we come in and connect to that bottom part, or that bottom oval, which the bottom oval actually becomes a wing. So we just drew like the turkey's belly. Now we need to add where the little legs come out. So it's like two little U's right next to each other. And then I erased the guideline that I had drawn before for the bottom of the belly. So now this is what we have. Two ovals followed by almost a question mark. All right, so now we're going to connect the back side by bringing a line down from the small oval and rounding a little bit in and then touching that bottom oval. So now it reminds me of a bowling pin somehow. And I'm going to put a little W shape, or a wavy line shape, like the W repeats itself over and over again, to add feathers, or a feather look at least, to this wing here. It's going to be the turkey's wing. Next, I will add the legs or the feet to the bottom of this turkey. And the turkey legs here are going to be rather short little legs before they come out to the separate little parts of the turkey feet. And I believe typically a turkey foot has three little toes coming out, and then one that kind of comes off of the turkey's leg itself, if you want to try to be accurate with that. But if you don't, no worries. Next, we will draw the beak of the turkey, followed by its little gobbler, or whatever that thing, waddler. I don't know what that thing is called, but I'm not a turkey farmer, that's for sure. And the last thing, well, not really last thing, but the next thing I will draw is the eye, which is just a quick circle right there. And then the last part that we will draw, finally the last part, is we will draw the feathers. So it's like making a bunch of arcs behind the turkey, a bunch of little arcs or little rainbows, little tiny rainbows behind the turkey to make all the little feathers for the back of the turkey. I don't know if you know much about turkeys. I obviously do not know very much by my lack of knowledge of the gobbler waddler situation, but anyways, I do know that it is the male turkeys that have these big feathers that stick up. They're not as big as a peacock's feathers by any means, but in the wild, if you've seen the turkeys, the males always have the much larger feathers sticking up, and they're usually dark brown in color and have some white variations in them and whatnot. Anyways, there's way more information about the turkey feathers than what you probably ever wanted to know. So I'm finishing up my turkey feathers here on this particular turkey. I think he's a decent looking turkey, but maybe you just don't like this style of turkey. Maybe you tried to draw it and you thought it did not look very good in your opinion. Or maybe you just want to try to draw a different kind of turkey. So I'm going to teach you how to draw a second kind of turkey. Okay, so that's turkey number one that we just finished. And here is turkey number two. All right, so for turkey number two, I again am going to have my paper going sideways like it's in a bath or sitting horizontally. Anyways, so I'm going to draw a oval again. This oval is larger and kind of more towards the center of my paper. And I find if you're trying to draw an oval and you're struggling with it, just go round and round in the shape that you would like, and eventually you will get the oval. And like I said, if you're drawing light till you've got it right, then you can erase anything that you did not like. I put a small little neck off to the side of that oval, and then I'm going to put a U on top of that neck. This turkey is going to have a pilgrim hat. So I will first start by drawing the bill of the pilgrim hat by going out from the side of that U and then rounding back in across the top of the U and then rounding back in again. And now I'm going to come up at an angle and then come across the top of where I want the hat. I don't know if you've ever seen a pilgrim hat, but they're kind of like a top hat that doesn't have straight sides. And then the next thing that I'm going to draw is on the turkey's face. So I need to draw the little beak. It comes out and rounds down, and then it'll round back in. And then you'll just have to erase a little bit of the side of the face inside of the beak there that you were drawing over. So remember, draw light till you got it right. I'll say that 100 times probably, and people still forget. Anyways, next two circles for the eyes. And then after the circles for the eyes, then we will draw the gobbler, or as we established, I'm not sure what the name of this thing is, but gobbler, waddler, something hanging off the front of the turkey, the male turkey. And after we finish with that, then guess what time it is? It is time for those awesome, amazing tail feathers. So we're going to come up, and then I will kind of judge at where I want all of my tail feathers by coming up several times. So you can decide how big you want this tail just by how many times you go out from the body of the turkey for the feathers. I have not put the tops on the feathers yet. And then you round the top of the feathers back down, nice rounded feathers. I mean, you could come up to a point if you like that look better. I have no idea why I actually decided to go with rounding, because I feel like coming up to a point would be more feather-like. I should have thought this out. Anyways, so I'm rounding for those tail feathers. I feel like every time I draw a turkey, I round the feathers. So if you like pointy feathers, you go for it. And then I'm going to put a wing on the side of the turkey, because the turkey has a wing, even though it doesn't use it. And next time for the feet. Now, I draw the feet, and you know, with this particular turkey, I accidentally drew the feet like straight down, and it really should be more like it's standing on those feet, not like it's just hanging there or on its tiptoes or anything, so I'll fix that later. Then I put in where the ground is and some background trees, and that's that turkey there. So, and of course, there are like bands of colors on a turkey's feathers. It's not actually colors, it's more like light areas. If you've ever looked at a picture of a turkey, you should. If you haven't, they're rather interesting to look at. So this is turkey number two. I hope you enjoyed drawing turkey number two if you followed me for turkey number two. But maybe you tried turkey number two, or maybe you didn't. And now you're ready for turkey number three. And we are going to do that right after we finish this turkey, of course. Okay, so there you have it, turkey number two. Now we will do turkey number three. So if you didn't like turkey one or two, hopefully number three is where it is at for you. And I have to admit, turkey number three is probably my favorite, but maybe it's just because he's a little wacky and a little tacky. So for turkey number three, we will draw a bigger oval. And you could trace something that is oval like this. You lay it down and you go and trace it. Now I will tell you that I chose a very poor object to trace, because then after I traced it, I noticed that it was not really shaped well. It's like kind of bent in on one side. So choose your object wisely. Anyways, so I'm going to draw an oval on the bottom half of my paper. And if you notice on this particular piece of paper, I'm holding my paper vertically, like it is in the shower instead of the paper in the bath. Don't put paper in the bath though. That would be bad. Anyways, so now I'm going to draw the neck of the turkey, and I start in the center of that oval, and I'm going to come up like I'm making a huge question mark. And when I get up to the top there, that's when I'm going to draw my circle for the head. So then I copy my question mark to make the back end of the neck, and then at the top I draw like a very elongated ovalish circle shape for the head. And again, I'm just cleaning up anything that I didn't like that I drew, because remember, if you draw light until you got it right, you'll always look good. I wish I had a rhyme second part of that. Yeah, need to work on that. Submit rhymes later. All right, so now I'm putting the beak on to the turkey, and I drew my waddler gobbler thing, and now the eye. And I think the reason this is my favorite turkey is because his neck is so awkward, and I kind of like weird awkward things, I guess. So that is essentially the turkey, and now we just need to draw those tail feathers. So coming up, rounding, and going back down. Again, as we established, you could bring those out to a point if you would rather. For some reason, as I draw all my turkeys, I round those tail feathers, and I didn't realize until this video that I did that with all of my turkeys. So now that's something I'm going to try at a later date, is to bring them out to a point, those feathers, sometime, just to see if I like it or not. Who knows? Maybe I do. All right, so I round the tail feathers, and you can put as many tail feathers back there as you want. Like, obviously, I'm putting a lot, but you might only like three or something, because this is your turkey, and you get to be as creative as you want with it and have fun. And then, after you finish the number of feathers that you want there, you're going to have to add the turkey legs. Oh, turkey leg. Do you like turkey legs? I think I'm more of a thigh person. Anyways, don't draw a big, thick alligator leg like that. That's ugly, yucky, yucky. Get rid of that. I don't know what I was thinking there. Maybe I thought it was an alligator for a second. Anyways, bring down a line on each side. And then you got to bring out your little turkey toes. Remember, the turkeys have like three toes, I think. And then a weird kind of one that comes off of its turkey leg part. I don't know. So, like I said, not a turkey farmer, just checked out some pictures one day. I'm giving a thickness to those legs. I had drawn them in with just one line, and now I'm drawing a second line right next to the line that I drew to give a thickness to the legs. Not too thick, because we know this part of the leg is not very thick at all. So, that is how to draw our third turkey. When you are finished drawing your turkey, you have to finish it up by coloring it in some awesome way. So I am going to do three different ways of finishing my turkey. And of course, you might not like any of these three ways, and you may choose to use markers instead, because that's one option that I did not use. The first option that I am doing here is I am going to paint. So I'm going to kick this into my high speed mode, and you can just watch me paint real quick, so that way I don't waste any of your creativity time. Thank you. The second medium that I will use is colored pencil. So with this one, I'm going to stick more natural colors. On the first turkey, I went a little more cartoonish just because it definitely felt like a cartoon turkey with that little hat on. Now with this one, I will stick with more natural colors, or at least try to, for a wild turkey. And I will again kick it into my high speed mode so I don't waste your creativity time with you watching me color. So there you have it with colored pencils. And here's what an actual wild turkey looks like, just in case you were wondering. And then for this last turkey, I'm going to use crayons. And again, one last time, I'm going to kick it into that high speed mode so you can see how I colored, but I'm not wasting your creativity time. So there you have it, three different turkeys drawn and finished three different ways. You can just choose which one is your favorite and see what happens when you create. Have a lot of fun, and I hope you enjoyed watching today's video.